But for them also, we cannot deny that there is Angushta Gana. The Angushta consists of Makaradvaja, Katakadvaja, Merupasha, Dvipasha, Tripasha, Shankha, and innumerable Sammuta, Sumukuta, Simhagranta, Agranta, Mugra, Pallava, Mrutupallava, Dhirga, Alochita, Chakragara, Bhutagara, Sastragara. Innumerable this type of things are there in the Angushta. On the basis of the chakra and the dots, a person's date of birth and time of birth and place of birth can be inferred. So Caesarean babies, as soon as they are matured by the age of one, immediately their prints must be taken for ascertaining the real time and place of birth. How it is distinct according to Shastras? According to Shastras, there are two kala. One is the Suryodaya kala and second is Shirapata kala. Shirapata, whenever the shiras, that is the head of the shishu, the embryo, that releases the head of the shishu, and whenever there is bahiprana shwasa, whenever that totally takes the breath inside from the bahiprana, the atmospheric oxygen, instead of the embryonic oxygen through the mother, when it takes the atmospheric oxygen, when it inhales, that is known as the time of birth. So this can be inferred even if the fullest delivery or the fullest release is reported by the doctor or nurses. We can infer some time, and according to Shodhana Padati and Sputa Padati, one can clearly understand when it should have or it would have released the head or taken the first inhalation. It can be done. And more than that, there is Garbharaksha in our Shastras. Garbharaksha. Garbharaksha includes three things. I gave some series of lectures on gynecology. It gives three benefits. If the child is inside the womb, we can do three things, three great wonders. It is known as bioarchitecture, theo-eugenics and genetic tailoring. We can do three things. One is shape beautification, structure rectification, characteristic or behavioral correction. Everything can be done by Sankalpa, Vrata, Anushtana, Samarpana and Sadhu Sangha, and lot of other innumerable good ways are there for getting that. So Garbha Raksha is also there in astrology, and Garbhadhana Muhurta is very important. Astrology does not only deal with your Ashubha and Shubha Muhurta. What you have already done, whatever that is Sadhya and Siddha, there are two things. That which automatically happens, for which you are not responsible, that which is optional, in which you can have a selective approach to that and create auspiciousness. So Muhurta is your optional status of creating auspiciousness. You are born inauspicious or semi-auspicious or extraordinarily dangerously auspicious. At this time, if you want to be beneficial to you and to the world, then you must shape it. You must channelize it by means of creating auspicious timings and activities. That is known as Muhurta. What is Muhurta? Muhurta is a suitable time for a suitable activity by which a person's auspicious standard is more shining. It is more enthralled, more engraved, more encoded, more vitalized. So that is known as Muhurta. So Garbhadhana Muhurta, it is a very, very vital part of astrology which is totally forgotten. We are making a chart for the National Institute of Fertility and Embryology. We are making a chart for Sattvika, Rajasa, Tamasa, Asura, Paishashika, Manusha, Deva, Siddha, Nidra, all of these classifications, temporal classifications for impartation, we are making the chart. Second is Udvaha. Now we are having only the Dashavida Yogyata by means of Stri, Dirga, Gana, Magendra, Vashya, Yoni, Veda. All of these things are very peripheral because they are concerned only with the constellations. The constellations for thousands of people. How you can match that? Apart from that, Parasparya, Sthana Parasparya of the person's Radhi Kundali, then the Navamsa Kundali, then Saptamastana, we have to make a Saptamamsha, and Saptavarga, and we have to finalize the decision. Apart from that, the third thing is Samskarabala. The Vivaha must be, the matrimonial ceremony must be performed as per the specifications of the Shastras. If you are contracting that, if you are simplifying that, then if you are just trampling on the heads of the sovereignty and independence of the ceremonial rights, which is just to further development and well-being, then certainly your results will also be contracted, simplified or trampled. So, Dashavidha, are the arghatas, what we call the arghata in Sanskrit. All of these matches are superficial, and sthana parasparya, each and everything must be perfectly matched, and that must be ensured by a ceremonial perfection by executing the matrimonial system as per the specification, inviolable injunctions of the Vedas. Then only you can get the benefit. Apart from that, we are having something, vanijya. There are a lot of things. Putra sankhya, somebody asked how to count the number of a person's sons and daughters. Then normally they used to say the place of the Putrasthana Adhipati from the Putrasthana is the count. It is just a very, very peripheral rule. How it can be possible for people having hundreds of children or more than children, more than nine? How it is possible for that? So putra sankhya, auchitya in vanidya and vidya, which faculty they want to study, how we can go deeper. For example, engineering is a faculty. We must select the deity or the corresponding planet for engineering. We can do that. How to select biotechnical engineering, marine engineering, aeronautical engineering, production engineering, textile engineering, instrumental engineering, how to select that? Is it possible by a mere prediction? So, auchitya means exact. Exact dealing with the particular persons, children, putra sankhya. Panijya auchitya, real mode of business that a person can select. Vidya auchitya, the real faculty or the disciplinary section that a person can select. It is only a divine prediction. And the normal predictions are there which can lead to a major standard. The subdivisions and the intricacies, complexities are understood only by divinity. So this is what we want to say. Apart from that, there are innumerable things. We can predict about political instability, enthronement, rethronement and dethronement of political parties, prediction of international relations, interreligious harmony, prediction of yuddha and kalaha, battle and wars, prediction of science and technology and innovations, prediction of prices, stability of the prices, instability like inflation, deflation, etc. So all of these things are possible, provided we must conduct each and every day a special class for prediction on economics, geopolitical economics, geoeconomical standards, national economy, our economy is financial standard. So starting from a person's monetary benefits, monetary, financial, fiscal, economical, and the whole global resources on broader and broadest areas, we can predict to that, provided we have all of these things. Then coming to the conclusion, I want to say we have an almanac. It is a manual for organizing ourselves. But who can read the almanac? And there are some people who can read only. That is the second thing, just already so. So how to utilize the almanac? A person was well trained with the almanac. So there are subtle transmissions. There are subtle transmissions and tangible transmissions. The Vakya Panchaka, the Vakya system of almanac, that deals with all the tangibility. And the subtle transmissions, by means of what we call depletion, or degradation, what you call geo-degradation, celestial degradation, planetary degradation, solar degradation, lunar degradation, cosmic degradation, galaxy degradation, all of the subtler points are included in the Drigvedic Panchaka. We have decided that for human beings who are subjected to transmissions and variations and degradations, for their interpretation, Drig Panchaka or Almanac has to be emphasized. And for all the divine festivations and other things, destiny of festivity, hilarity and celebrity in temples as per the rituals and rites, they made that as this type of subtle transmissions will not affect that of the divine standards which are ever perplenary and replenishable. So for them it is not so much apt. So they have used to Vakya Panchaka. This is the statement. Now coming to the conclusion point, astrology, it is not just like what we are hearing. The daily predictions are given in television channel, weekly predictions and monthly predictions are given in these channels. Unless the persons are serious, they cannot interpret like that. How they can do that? The totally substandard, the real origination of the Vedic astrology. I want to say something. There are three major philosophies or principles of life, of wisdom. They are, God is sustaining everybody. God is sustaining everybody. But God is sustained by three principles. One is Ayurveda, second is Yoga, third is Jyotisha. If these three things are properly practiced, that will make people believe that there is something beyond us. There is karma. Then they will believe karma. Then they will believe dharma. Then they will believe shastra. Then they will believe devata. Then they will do bhakti. Then there will be prosperity and harmony in the world. If that is wrong, misinterpreted, or semi-baked interpretations are given by baked personalities, then certainly it will spoil the theistic belief in the society, resulting in non-belief of karma, which results in non-belief of dharma, non-belief of shastras, non-belief of paradevata, non-belief of bhakti, non-belief of all of these things will result in total disharmony and chaos in the society. So each and every astrologer is establishing the kingdom of God. He is giving comfort and solace to God. Who is giving comfort and solace to everybody? If a person is properly predicting, then God, very deeply he exists. A real person, he has established my veritability and existence. God is happy when these three things are the visible proofs. All the other sciences like eschatology, then metaphysics, cosmology, agathology, various other sciences are there. Those sciences are beyond the pursuit of human intellect. These sciences are limited. Ayurveda, it gives you proper physical salubrity and mental peace. Yoga gives you enlightenment and emancipation. And this particular life management science known as Jyotisha that makes all persons to lead in all walks of life with all-round success, comfort, contentment and wisdom.